All right, everybody, back on the Tudor rear spring. We're swapping an old Yankee Speedco main leaf into the spring pack. I got to cut the old spring pack open, clean up all the gunk and stuff that's on it. Inside might be clean, but the outside was wrapped in metal. And the center bolt of the spring actually has a grease fitting on it. There must be holes inside the bolt, so you can grease it up. Which is pretty cool. It saves it. So it's probably a really clean spring, but so much grease and dirt over the years that it's very nasty. So I'm going to be working on taking that apart and kind of cleaning stuff up. So it's going to be a dirty, dirty night. It's not even daytime. As you can see by the windows, blacked out. And you probably saw something else over there. That's Kelly's new tool. I told you guys we were making room. So I moved a bunch of stuff over here, over there in the corner, made space in this corner for Kelly's new tool. I don't know if she's came out with it in her video. It's coming out here. So, there it is, an Eastwood B120 blast cabinet. Oh, so you know, it's a pretty decent size, 4 foot wide, 2 foot deep, and it's not quite 2 feet high. It's like 22 inches, but it's also has this angle, so you can't put something square in there, obviously, and you wouldn't want to. But you know, there's quite a bit of space in here. We just need to get some blast media and you know, get going on it. I hope our compressor can keep up with some sandblasting. Regardless, this isn't part of the spring, but figured I'd show you guys since you're going to see it and probably ask, what's the deal with that blast cabinet? That's the deal. So back to the spring. Here is the old Yankee main leaf, 37 to 40. And when they do their reverse size, they do de-arch it a bit. Just to get even lower. So it's not just going to lower the height of this, which is probably about an inch or so. It's also going to lower it because this main leaf is de-arched. So don't think when you buy this, you're just going to get an inch lower. It's going to lower you quite a bit, probably around 2 inches. We're going to take this one apart and see how nasty, mucky stuff. Yeah. Not fun. So, I don't know if I have a tarp or something. I might try and find something, put it down before I start taking this apart. But, yeah. Slice into it, cut into it. I don't know what I'm going to do here. We'll find out, though. I know, no glasses. I can't find the damn things. I know it's no excuse, but that's my excuse. Oh my god. Look at this. It's pretty cool. Looks like I'm opening up a creature from a different planet. It's a bunch of spines and stuff. But yeah, it's just cloth wrapped. These springs are mint. Cloth wrapped springs and then metal around it and just pump the grease in there. Man, Cool. All right, so when I was taking this apart, you know, scraping off all the stuff and not paying attention, I looked over to do this side, and you can probably tell the difference here. Main leaf was broken in half. I don't know for how long, and the only thing holding it on was the metal and the straps. So that was dangerous. I'm glad we only took a ride down the street, because that is dangerous. That's why you always lower your car, go to Millwork's website, get by everything Old Yankee, to lower your car so you can check your suspension. Make sure it ain't broke, because these springs are old and they get abused. So yeah, go Old Yankee. Fix your suspension. That looks like a 9/16. It's all gross. I don't feel like getting nasty tonight, even though it's inevitable. Because there's going to be a point where I'm going to get aggravated at something, and I'm going to rip my gloves off, and then I'm just going to get dirty. I hope it doesn't happen, though. I hope this goes smooth, and I'm relaxed all night. Everything's hunky-dory. Oh my gosh. I just pulled this off with my finger. So that shouldn't happen. Well, that's off. Okay. I hope this bolt is nice because it's been soaking in grease for years. And I can just reuse it because it's a pretty cool bolt. Anyway. Man, this bolt does not want to come out. This stupid main leaf can leave. That's not gonna get used anytime soon. Or ever. Actually. Never mind. I don't think this is coming out either. Since that was loose, the side of this spring hole has been rubbing on the spring, on the bolt. Well, the side of the spring holes have been rubbing on this bolt and made a bunch of ridges in it. So I honestly don't think it's going to, I don't think it's gonna work. And honestly, I don't see any holes in this bolt. How the heck? Oh, that's weird. So there's holes. There's slits in the threads, so when you put grease in here, it literally just passes through the threads. So I can just use this nut, and I don't have to use this. I don't think I'm ever going to grease it, but it's still kind of funky. All right, so I got the main leaf here. I don't think this bottom leaf will work. No. Okay, so the bottom leaf's got to come out. Which is fine with me. Lower the better. Cool. These. I was trying to think if I should take any more out than this. Top and the bottom one. Oh no. This is the top one. This is the cap. So take that one off. Yeah, see? See how that does. Probably gonna be a bad idea because it's, you know, a lot of bad ideas.
Wow.
And I'm putting it together outside of the car. You know, against strict orders from a bunch of people, because I'm using the longer shackle ends, so I think I'm gonna be all right. I think I'm gonna be okay. And I kept the grease on here because I want the spring to work well. I don't know, hokey spring here. Oh no. I ran out of threads. Is it seriously this thickness? No. No, even with this one, it would have been... Damn it. Nope, I'm cutting it. I'm not taking the nut all the way off. That would be stupid. Okay. Cutting it. My safety squints. What the heck? If it's a little high in the back, I'll have a little rake. Or do I? Man. I'm in a pickle. I want to be low, but I don't want to be too low. Well, you know, if the spring's too low, I can always just change out the shackles. You know what? No. I'm putting that spring back in. And yeah. Because I'm using the shackles, I'll get lower than I wanted to anyway. And then if I'm too low, I'll just take the shackles out, like I did in the front. But I think I'll be fine. I don't think there's such thing as too low in the back because, you know, it's not going to affect anything. You know what I'm saying? Like, if the wheels don't have to turn back there, nothing like that. So as long as I ain't touching the fender, I should be good. And I think I'm going to be good. I think this is gonna be good. Alright. I need to get my. I don't know why I have my ears on. There's no reason to have my ears on. Look at that! Two wrenches I used for something else. Coming in handy. 3/4 and a 9/16. Bada-bing! There it is. Baby! So, one less spring than normal. Alright. I think it's good enough that I can clean up this mess. And I was talking to Matt Firestone He owns Old Yankee Speed Co. And he said, watch out for the material, the cloth material that's in these springs. It's asbestos. So just be careful with it, all right? I just knocked that seized in shackle out. I don't think I'm gonna be making any noise out here anymore because it's almost 9 o'clock and I'm out in the driveway and I got close neighbors and I have to saw out the bushing that's on each side of these spring hangers. I'm not about to do that right now, so I want to, trust me. I'll just cut out, smash it out, be done with it. But can't do tomorrow or something. One step closer to the spring. One step closer. I think we should be all right. I want to measure it actually and see how hard it's going to be to put the shackles in with the spring together. That might be a good idea. Oh, this is gonna be a money shot. It's gonna be easy. Okay, this no worries here. Once those bushings are out of the rear spring hangers, this thing's going in 5 minutes, maybe 10. All new hardware. All I gotta do is push these neoprene or whatever, I don't know what these are made out of, bushings in the spring hangers on the car. Put the shafts in, pound them in with a little plastic mallet, and we're golden. Put spring on, put the hangers on, tighten it up, drop it down. Do it pretty good.
Is it?
Was it still on record?
Yes. Yeah, you got 14 minutes here.
Alright. I guess we'll try to knock it out with something.
Yeah, what? Stop.
Alright, so finally, we got these stupid things out. Stupid bushings. Now putting the nice polyurethane ones in. These are so much easier. Especially when you gotta replace them. It's just a little polyurethane to cut instead of a drum of steel that doesn't want to, doesn't want to get cut. Where's the little boy?
Little boy's over there.
Okay.
feel like these are long enough that we don't have to like compress the spring at all to get these on.
I really hope that's the case.
Yeah. I kind of measured it and it seemed like it was the case.
Get this thing low.
I know. Yeah, that would. That would just really get it low.
Yeah. Yeah, giant shackles and a reverse eye sounds like good enough.
You know what? Only the back one, because I'm going to have to put this on.
Huh?
I can only do the back one, because I got to put this on.
Oh, yeah, over the spring.
Yeah.
Stuff's freezing fast.
Is it?
Yep. I look down, it's like just this perfect boot print.
Crying,
buddy. Hey. You know what? It actually looks like it'll work.
Oh. It'd be perfect. But is it going to be too low?
But that never happens.
Yeah.
Where's the little boy going?
Inside.
Yeah, he wants to drill. Oh, it's gonna hit. Yeah, not quite. Huh? Maybe. There you go.
In it?
It looks it. You're in the middle. Oh, there we go.
Slam my face. There it is.
Sick. Well, that was easier than the front.
But now with this though, this could be kind of spread.
What do you mean?
Oh
shit. Whew. What, getting those, the front one to line up?
Oh my god. Disaster.
I wish we were like actually recording while we were doing the front.
Yeah, because it was hell.
That was a panic.
Yeah, this makes it look like everyone's gonna be like, oh, what were you crying about?
I know. That's so easy.
No, well, easy.
Everyone said the rear is easier than the front.
The rear is a lot easier than the front. This is like ridiculous.
Wanna give me a 916?
Yeah.
Whatever this is.
Yeah.
In case it's not.
It's in the center, right?
Let me see. Yeah. Yep.
What? What?
Dead?
Yeah, whatever.
All the rust.
All my batteries are dead. No, this is just a dirt.
I hope.
Everything's covered in dirt.
All right, well, did it die in the right amount of time? Is this thing all ready to go?
No, it needs to be tightened. This is...
Oh, sick.
Still loose.
Cool.
But yeah, pretty much, we're almost ready to put it on the ground, see how low it is first. I'll add the cotter pins on these shackles later.
Yeah.
But I just want to see how low it goes.
Yeah, same. Well, if it looks like that when it gets lowered, it'll be pretty cool.
Should be lower than that. I need a block, bigger block of wood.
Is this good?
Yeah, I guess. I still have the block of wood from the tire.
Yeah, all the other wood's been like broken up and stuff. Yay. You mean like just kick it?
No, we're gonna have to put the jack's ends onto the axle right after we. Right after it like lifts off of them. I don't like this. Oh, it's up. I'll hold this. Go get the
jack's ends. We need to get a real jack.
Oh yeah, record it.
Yeah. Much lower in the back.
Much cooler. It's not very small.
It takes a while. All right, so here it is. You can't really see it right now, but once we pull it out, well, if we pull it out, you'll see. Right up to the top of the white wall, which is perfectly where I wanted it. Got to find some 15s and throw some big 15s on there. I don't know what size is a big rear for a 15, but so I got 15s on this thing all the way around, so it's no confusion when buying tires or something. I'm gonna slap this fancy new grill on there and it'll look way better. I don't know if you can see this side. Yeah. Now it sits right. So radiator. Radiator, grill, shocks, and then window seals and all that BS. So there's a bunch to do on this thing, but at least I knocked the suspension out. So now it's just really shocks for the suspension. So I really didn't knock it out, but springs are done. And it's sitting the way I want it. Alright, so the other day, well, this is the same video for you guys, but the other day, I dropped the spring, I dropped the rear end of the 40, but I never really pulled it out to see what it looks like, so let's do that. Snowy day, you know, not gonna see much, but I wanna pull this thing out and see what it looks like. Leaky. Oh yeah, leaking under the dash. Great. I'm gonna take the snow off of it.
Definitely a lot cooler. Nice and low. That's the old girl. Didn't get some tube shocks in her yet, but she'll be good.